Hello! This is a time machine, and for today's lesson, I'm going to take us back 13 billion years. Unfortunately, the maximum it can go is 4 seconds, so I'll just be really descriptive. Hi, I'm Rachel Hansen, and this is Unit 2, The Big Bang. Check this out. This picture may be the closest thing we have to a time machine, because it's showing us something from 13 billion years ago. How? Well, not by using an ordinary camera. This image was taken by the Hubble Space Telescope in 2003. There are 10,000 galaxies in this picture. Some of those tiny red ones are so far away that the light from them that's reaching us today is from, yes, 13 billion years ago. This picture lets us peer back into the earliest days of our universe. And this is only a sliver of our night sky. If you were standing on Earth and looking up, this image occupies a space just 1/10 the size of the full moon. To make this one tiny picture of our unimaginably huge universe, it took hundreds of scientists and engineers, 400 orbits around Earth, 4 months, and one awesome telescope. But it also took thousands of years and generations of thinkers taking chances, making mistakes, and progressing our understanding of the size, nature, and origins of the universe. Edwin Hubble, that's the guy who the telescope is named for, first proved in 1924 that other galaxies existed. He showed us that the universe was so much bigger than we thought, but he didn't stop there. In 1929, he formulated Hubble's Law. Not the kind of law where you get in trouble for breaking it, but one of those, this is just how it is laws. Hubble's Law helped provide evidence that the universe is expanding. His work supports a theory proposed by George Lemaître just 2 years earlier, the Big Bang Theory. That probably sounds like way too much science for a history class. But that's like saying that a history of Rome has too many Romans. Science is a part of history, and history can help us explain how we know what we know. It shows us how science changed over time, and it can reveal how changes in our knowledge transformed our societies. Take Edwin Hubble. It's thanks to his discoveries that we understand the size and origins of our universe. But he built on the ideas and discoveries of other astronomers in the early 20th century, like Henrietta Leavitt, Albert Einstein, Harlow Shapley, and George Lemaître. And these scholars built on the work of scholars from centuries earlier. Ancient Greeks like Claudius Ptolemy asserted that the universe revolved around the Earth. Generations of Arab, Persian, Chinese, and other astronomers improved on Ptolemy's calculations. Then, in the 16th century, Nicholas Copernicus asserted that, actually, the sun sat at the center of the cosmos. Everyone was like, wait, what? From there, step by step, discovery by discovery, we move closer to the understandings that allowed Hubble to make his breakthrough. And his breakthroughs allowed later astronomers to improve on his work and develop new ideas and discoveries, refining our understanding of space-time, the earliest days of our universe, and how to capture a picture like this. Even today, our understanding of the beginning of time and our universe continues to evolve with each new discovery. In Unit 1, we defined big history. It's the modern scientific origin story backed by historical and scientific evidence that tells the history of the universe and our place in it. You learned that this class is about the history of human thought. If this were a science class, we'd teach what scientists discovered and how they did it. But this course, this history course, is about learning how our knowledge of the universe and everything in it has changed over time. That means that sometimes we'll need some knowledge of scientific concepts. So while this unit may seem like it's all about the Big Bang, It's really about the way humans have answered the question, where did we come from? In the first unit, we also examined the concept of scale and how our perspective changes, whether we're zooming in on a tiny grain of sand or out to an entire planet. Then we explored how different human societies explain the origins of our world. We also learned about claim testing and how you can evaluate the narratives you encounter. And finally, we met 8 new friends, the thresholds of increasing complexity. Each threshold marks a moment in time when just the right ingredients came together under just the right Goldilocks conditions to create something more complex in our universe. The Big Bang is the first threshold of increasing complexity. What is the Big Bang? And how do we know that it's the origin story of our universe? Those are the 2 big questions you'll tackle in this unit. The Big Bang is a scientific theory. It claims that the universe started out incredibly, unimaginably small, hot, and dense. Then, for some reason we still don't know, it rapidly expanded. This was the beginning of time and space and everything else in our universe. All the ingredients for stars, planets, mountains, polar bears, daffodils, and your lunch were born in this instant. But how did scientists come up with the theory? It took centuries of careful observations, the development of new technologies, and new ways of thinking to get a 21st century model of our universe. In this unit, you'll travel back in time to meet scholars like Ptolemy, Nasir al-Din al-Tusi, Copernicus, Galileo, and Hubble. You'll ask how each explained the origins of the universe and how each built on older knowledge to update our modern scientific origin story. The way that humans build and improve on knowledge over time is called collective learning, and you're going to hear a lot more about it throughout this course. And guess what? We still don't know everything. Each generation of scholars continues to build on the past. In this unit, you'll also see how different disciplines study the origins of the universe in different ways. Scholars from a wide variety of disciplines, such as physics, astronomy, cosmology, chemistry, geology, biology, and history, have all helped us understand the universe and our place in it. That's a lot of information in one short video. So let's do a quick recap. Big history is organized around 8 thresholds of increasing complexity. And the first is, say it with me, the Big Bang. Now, we don't know a lot about what happened before the Big Bang, but we do have a lot of evidence about what happened in the moments just after, as the universe was born, expanded, and cooled over time. We also have centuries of scholarly works on the history of the universe. These scholars are legitimate authorities who used evidence to develop ideas that were then shared, tested, and improved upon by other scholars over time. I don't want to brag, but I just name-dropped not 1, but 2 claim testers. Evidence and authority to help explain the Big Bang. As you go through the lessons in this unit, think about the evidence that supports the Big Bang theory. Also think about the authorities who support, extend, or challenge this evidence. Then, as you move through the unit, put the evidence and authority together with your intuition and logic to evaluate the Big Bang theory. When you use all 4 of the claim testers to evaluate a particular topic, you're well on your way to becoming a big historian. I wonder if this thing can go 4 seconds into the future. It worked. What did I miss?